My name is Uma Habiba, and today the topic of my presentation is emulsifiers. First of all, I would like to define emulsifiers. The chemical additive that encourages the suspension of one liquid in another, as a mixture of oil and water in margarine, is called emulsifiers. Simply, the emulsifiers are used to mix two immiscible liquids. We use emulsifiers to mix these two immiscible liquids. And examples are egg yolks, mustard, soy lecithin, alkali soap, and polysorbate. These two are synthetic emulsifiers, and egg yolks, mustard, and soy lecithin are natural emulsifiers. Then, using industry. Emulsifiers are used in the industry for emulsions. Most common emulsion is water oil emulsion. Emulsifiers keep suspended particles of oil in water or water in oil. It representing the oil water emulsion, and this is the water oil emulsion. And the common applications of these two emulsions in the food industry include mayonnaise and ice cream, etc. Then, chemistry of the emulsifiers. An emulsifier consists of the hydrophilic water soluble part and lipophilic oil soluble part. It is the diagram which representing the structure of the emulsifiers. It is the hydrophilic head, and it is the hydrophobic tail. And its head is water soluble part, and its tail is oil soluble part. Then, characteristics of the emulsifiers. Emulsifiers are very useful in all types of emulsions and in water oil emulsion. They make both of them completely dispersed in each other, creating a stable, homogeneous, smooth emulsion. Emulsions have a big effect on structure and texture of many foods. They are used to aid in processing of foods. And emulsifiers are useful in emulsions in food industry. And they are also important in other industries because they are very close to stabilizers. So emulsifiers increase shelf life of any product. The classification of the emulsifiers is given. The general classification of the emulsifier is, emulsifiers are classified into two basic classes, non-ionic and ionic. And the ionic emulsifiers are further divided into anionic, cationic, and amphoteric. And these are the examples of the anionic emulsifiers, cationic, and amphoteric. First of all, I would like to discuss non-ionic emulsifiers. And the definition of the non-ionic emulsifier is, the non-ionic emulsifier is an APO-free emulsifier which is widely used in industries and are ideally suitable for emulsification of difficult to emulsify the systems. In fact, it is the APEO-free emulsifier, and APEO stands for alkyl phenol ethoxylates, which are non-ionic surfactants consisted of branched chain alkyl phenols which have been reacted with ethylene oxide producing an ethoxylate chain. Then, example of the non-ionic emulsifiers. Most common examples of the non-ionic emulsifiers are fatty acid monoglycerides, sorbitan fatty acid esters, sugar esters, and derivatives of the polyoxyethylene fatty alcohol esters, fatty acid sorbitan fatty acid esters, hydrogenated castor oil. Then, applications of the non-ionic emulsifiers in industries. Non-ionic emulsifiers can be used in industries as industrial cleaners, stabilizers, deforming agents, sanitizers, because they are very close to surfactants, so they are also used as sanitizers, and they can be used as agrochemical emulsifiers. And the second basic part and type of the emulsifiers are the ionic emulsifiers. Ionic emulsifiers are a combination of highly charged end of a molecule which is attracted to water with a very low charge backbone which has an affinity to oil and waxes. For example, fatty acid soaps, fatty acid alcohol, sulfates. And ionic emulsifiers have three basic types, cationic, anionic, and amphoteric. First of all, cationic emulsifiers. Cationic emulsifiers offer formulated a new tool in developing products which meet consumer demands. The unique properties of the cationic emulsifiers enable development of highly lipophilic system that offer enhanced consumer benefits without sacrificing aesthetics. And cationic emulsifiers offer water resistance properties and excellent cost or performance ratio. These are the examples of the cationic emulsifiers, cetrimide and benzalkonium chloride. It is the structure of the cetrimide and it is the structure of the benzalkonium chloride. It is the open structure which represents the benzene reaction. Number of carbon varies from 8, 10, 12, 14, and so on. And it is the cyclic structure of the benzalkonium chloride. And the next type is amphoteric emulsifier. An amphoteric emulsifier is a compound that contains anionic as well as cationic hydrophilic group. Amphoteric emulsifiers help in improving blending and moisture retention, enhance mouthfeel, etc. Amphoteric emulsifiers are used in preparation of various food items such as bakery products like bread and biscuits, etc. The most important example of the amphoteric emulsifier is lecithin. Lecithin is a natural emulsifier and it is one of the classes of lipids, which is phospholipids, and it is the structure of the lecithin, which represents the hydrophilic head and hydrophobic tail. And its structure consists of five smaller molecules and has a backbone of the glycerol that bonds up to three other molecules or fatty acids. Hydrophobic, they give lecithin a structure of fatty acids like the structure of lecithin resembles to the structure of the fats or any other like lipids. And in the industry, there are three types of industry emulsifiers are classified on the basis of the mechanism of action. On the basis of the mechanism of action, emulsifiers are divided into three main types: unimolecular, multimolecular, and solid particle. Finally, solid divided particles. And it is the diagram which represents structure which is showing unimolecular film and multimolecular film, solid particle film, how emulsifier act on these three films. Mechanism of emulsifiers. First of all, monomolecular film emulsifying agents with stabilizing action from molecular at oil-water interface. This monolayer prevents coalescence of droplets. And the mechanism of action includes reduction of the interfacial tension. First of all, reduction of the interfacial retention takes place, then from coherent monolayer to prevent the coalescence of two droplets when they approach each other. And the third step of the mechanism of the monomolecular film is provide surface charge which causes repulsion between adjacent particles. And if, for example, sorbitan monopolyate and polyoxyethylene. The second type in the chemical industry of the emulsifier is multimolecular film, or you can say hydrophilic colloids. The mechanism of the action of these emulsifiers is completed in three steps. First of all, strong film is formed by the hydrocolloids. When the strong film is formed, then it produces oil and water emulsion. After producing emulsion, they have low effect on the surface tension. It is monomolecular film. This is the diagram which is representing monomolecular film, and it is representing multimolecular film. Particulate film. There also got particulate films, and it is finely divided solid particles. The mechanism of action of these emulsifiers is given. First of all, it forms a particulate film around dispersed particles. And at the second step, these particles rely on adsorption to interfaces, and like hydrophilic colloids, function by forming a physical barrier to coalescence. Then the third point of its mechanism in finely divided solid particles that are wetted to some degree by both oil and water act as emulsifying agents. This results from they're being concentrated at interface where they produce a particulate film around that is first droplets to prevent the coalescence. And it is the diagram which is representing solid particle film. So the application of the emulsifiers in the food industry, application in batch enhancing the dough's air holding capacity and resistance, fermentation capacity, significantly increasing volume of the bread. And the second important point of the emulsifiers in the food industry is improving the internal structure to make it uniform, fine, white, and good layers. Delay the aging of starch, make products soft, and extend freshness period of the bread. And the second application in the food industry is in biscuits and cookies, avoid surface foaming, reduce amount of grease, and improve the formation and uniformity of gluten, and make the product not easy happening as shrinking and deformation. And then application in cake, significantly increase the volume of the cake, improve the texture and make the taste more delicious. Then in ice cream, improve the whipping properties, make the ice cream richer in aroma, sweeter, softer, and more delicate. It is application in milk beverages, improve the stability and dispersibility of beverages, prevent the occurrence of the starch emulsions, improve the uniformity and taste of the products. So there were three main types of emulsifiers on the basis of the mechanism of action in the chemical industry, which are monomolecular, multimolecular, and finally divided solid particles. And generally, they are divided into two parts, which are non-ionic and ionic. And the ionic includes cationic, anionic, and amphoteric. So attend applications in the cosmetic industry. In the cosmetic industry, emulsifiers are used in various cosmetic products such as moisturizers, gel creams, cleansers, multiple emollients, sunscreens, emulsifier-free, water-free, body butters, mild formulation, preservative-free, after-sun products, perfume creams. And in cosmetic industry and in food industry, they can also be used in textile industry. And the overall advantages of the emulsifiers are, some of the advantages of emulsifiers include they are non-irritating, highly compatible with fatty esters, long-lasting, silky afterfeel, outstanding emollency, and benefits recognizable at low use levels, because the excess use of the emulsifiers can harm the product, and broad pH functionality and compatible with fatty esters. Thank you.
अच्छा ये अपना मैं अभी भाई एक तो ये लफ्स एस्टर होता है ठीक है ईस्टर नहीं होता
जी
ठीक है एस्टर्स का ग्रुप का आपको पता है ये कार्बोक्सिलिक एसिड के एच की जगह पे अगर आप आर ग्रुप लगा दें तो एस्टर ग्रुप बन जाता है और बाज जैसे अमाइंस को अमीन्स वहां पे पढ़ते हैं लेकिन एस्टर्स को एस्टर ही लोग ज्यादा बोलते हैं जो ज्यादा कॉमनली है और अच्छा था आपका सारा ठीक था मैकेनिज्म जो आपने बताया है ये जरा दोबारा बताइएगा उर्दू में क्या आपकी वो स्लाइड हिल रही थी को समझ सही तरह से पता नहीं लगा बाकियों को भी मेरा ख्याल पता नहीं लगा होगा
सर मेरा वो एनआईनी के मल्सिफायर वाला भी एक पेज रह गया वो भी पढ़ दूं
हाँ जी बता दें कोई बात अगर आप वीडियो दोबारा कर ऑन करके करना चाहते हैं देख लें जैसे आपको ठीक लगता है
anionic emulsifier, a blend of anionic and ionic surfactants can used for formulating oil in water emulsion, especially low solids emulsion fluids. The main characteristic of the anionic emulsifiers is anionic emulsifiers lower the interfacial tension between water and oil. The lowering of interfacial tension allows for oil wetting of steel and solid surfaces. Anionic emulsifiers are very common and cheap. Anionic emulsifiers give negative charge to oil drop that in MIA. So the example is anionic soap. When it reacts with the carboxyl group and you can use sodium hydroxide or potassium hydroxide, it gives the carboxylate ion and the byproduct is water. So it is the preparation of the anionic soap, which is the example of the anionic emulsifiers.
महबीबा, इसका मैकेनिज्म जो है ना, इस इमल्सीफायर इमल्सीफाई कैसे करता है? नहीं, ये कैसे इमल्सीफाई करता है? दूसरी बात ये कि आपने ये जो इमल्शन बताए हैं, ऑयल इन वाटर का है या वाटर इन ऑयल का है, दोनों का फंक्शन अलग होता है किस तरह से? मतलब उसकी कोई आपने अलग से इमल्शन की टाइप्स होती हैं? जैसे मतलब ऑयल के अंदर पानी डालना, ठीक है, और एक होता है पानी के अंदर ऑयल डालना, ऑयल के ड्रॉपलेट्स होते हैं, पानी ज्यादा होता है ऑयल कम होता है, एक होता है कि ऑयल बहुत ज्यादा होता है पानी कम होता है, तो दोनों का इमल्शन बनाने के लिए दो डिफरेंट टाइप्स होती है ना?
यस सर।
इस बारे में नहीं पढ़ा कोई आपने?
सर पढ़ा था, लेकिन वो उसमें फूड इंडस्ट्री में उसकी एप्लीकेशंस पड़ी थी बस।
नहीं नहीं, ये तो हर जगह पे है। आपको देखें, दो चीजें होती हैं, एक आपको मटेरियल ना मिले तब आप टीचर से पूछें, एक आपको समझ ना आए तब भी आप टीचर से पूछें। जब आपको खुद समझ नहीं आएगी तो आप कैसे, ये प्रेजेंटेशन का मतलब ये नहीं होता जस्ट आपने कॉपी पेस्ट करके रीडिंग करनी है। आप अज्यूम ये किया जाता है कि आपको सब अच्छे तरीके से समझ है इसकी ना, और जहां पर कोई कंफ्यूजन हो तो वो आप, अब आप ये बताएं कि इमल्शन का काम क्या होता है बेसिकली?
इमल्शन का काम होता है दो लिक्विड्स को मिक्स करना, जो
इमिसिबल, ठीक है ना,
इमिसिबल लिक्विड्स या जो डिफरेंट नेचर के होते हैं।
हाँ जी, जो आपस में मिक्स अप वैसे नहीं हो सकते, जैसे आप सरसों के तेल में पानी मिलाएं, उस शीशी को हिलाएं, थोड़ी देर बाद मिक्स हो जाएगा, लेकिन बाद में रखी रखेंगे ऑयल ऊपर आ जाएगा, पानी की लेयर उसकी अलग हो जाएगी, ठीक है? तो इनको अगर मिक्स करना हो आपस में तो इसके लिए हम इमल्सीफायर यूज करते हैं, जो कि दोनों को सिंगल फेज में कन्वर्ट कर देता है, और वो फिर लॉन्गर पीरियड ऑफ टाइम के लिए एक ही फेज में रहते हैं और अप्लाई होते हैं, ठीक है? इसमें जैसे सिलिकॉन ऑयल्स हैं और उसके अंदर हम इमल्सीफायर यूज करते हैं। एक आपने यहाँ पे टर्म बोला APEO, ठीक है, इथॉक्सिलेट फ्री। अच्छा, ये क्या चक्कर है APEO का?
सर क्योंकि उन्होंने लिखा हुआ था कि जो इमल्सीफायर होता है ये ब्लेंड होता है आयनिक एंड नॉन आयनिक सरफेक्टेंट का, लेकिन जो नॉन आयनिक इमल्सीफायर है वो APEO फ्री होता है, लाइक इसमें इन और जो है वो नॉन आयनिक सरफेक्टेंट नहीं होता, ये फ्री होता है उससे।
क्या मतलब अगर APEO फ्री नहीं होगा तो क्या होगा?
तो ये नॉन आयनिक होगा।
ये ना असल में मैं आपको बताता हूँ इसका, अगर आप डिटेल APEO पे क्लिक करते ना तो आपको इसकी बहुत डिटेल मिलनी थी। ये पहले इमल्सीफायर जो होते थे वो फिनोल बेस होते थे, नोनाइल फिनोल वगैरह ना, NP9, NP10, NP11, 12, ठीक है, उसकी बेस पे हम इमल्सीफायर की सिलेक्शन होती थी। वो फिर बैन हो गए क्योंकि वो फिश टॉक्सिक थे, वो जब आपके वाटर स्ट्रीम में जाते हैं तो वहां पर फिश के लिए डेंजरस हैं, तो वो बैन हो गए। अब जो हमारे पास इमल्सीफायर आजकल यूज होते हैं वो APEO फ्री होते हैं, उसके अंदर ऐसा कोई कंटेंट नहीं होता जो कि डेंजरस हो, ये है उसकी लॉजिक ना, अदरवाइज वो इमल्सीफायर बहुत अच्छे होते थे। अब आप ये बताएं कि इसके लिए जो HLB वैल्यू का आपने कुछ जिक्र नहीं किया, हाइड्रोफिलिक लाइपोफिलिक इस तरह का कोई लफ्ज, उनका बैलेंस वो कैसे, उसकी किसकी बेस पे हम इमल्सीफायर सिलेक्ट करते हैं, हमने इमल्सीफायर कितने टाइप्स के होते हैं, अब हमें कैसे पता चलेगा हमने जिस प्रोसेस में, केमिस्ट्री के प्रोसेस में हमने जो इमल्सीफायर यूज करना है वो आया किस टाइप का होगा? ये बड़ा रिस्पॉन्सिबल टॉपिक था आपका, और ये मतलब समझने जैसे सर्फेक्टेंट डिटर्जेंट के साथ ये बिल्कुल साथ जुड़ा हुआ है ये, और ये एक जान है इस मतलब सारी केमिस्ट्री की, इमल्सीफायर केमिस्ट्री जो होती है ना, ये केमिस्ट्री की आप समझ लें रिएक्शंस की बेसिक्स हैं ये भी, इनको आप छोड़ नहीं सकते कि इसके बगैर आप क्लियर अंडरस्टैंडिंग ना लें। चलिए आप मटेरियल भेजिए, मैं फिर अपने पास से करके इसको तैयार, फिर मैं क्लास में आप लोगों को समझाता हूँ सारा। आप आपने जो मटेरियल बनाया मुझे ईमेल कर दिया आपने?
जी कर दिया। और ये जो नया ऐड किया ये नहीं किया, ये कर दूंगी आज।
हाँ जी, करके फिर मुझे एक ही फाइल आप डेटेड लफ्ज आगे लिख दीजिएगा, ठीक है?
जी ठीक,
ताकि वो पुरानी नई मिक्स ना हो। ये जो आप ईमेल करेंगे उसकी जो फाइल बनाएंगे पीडीएफ या जो भी बनानी है उसके साथ भी अपडेट का लफ्ज लिख दीजिएगा और ईमेल में भी अपडेट का लफ्ज लिख दीजिएगा।
जी ठीक है,
ठीक है, चलें आप एंजॉय करें।